ברוך השם, אהבת חלת מפתח, כי חלה ברוך השם, we are meeting again after Pesach, we are already in ספירת העומר. I would like to bless all of us, בסייעתא דשמיא, שיתגלה משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן. שיגיע המבשר אליהו, הנביא אליהו, התשבי אליהו הגלעדי, במהרה יבואנו משיח דוד אליהו הנביא זכור לטוב. דיה ליידיז. This parasha, this is week's parasha, it's two parashiot, two portions, it's Tazria Metzora. Hashem gave me the zchut to give lessons, Torah lessons about Tazria Metzora. Please go to torahanytime.com or rabbanitirz.com or the YouTube. Racheli puts down also on the YouTube for the people that don't know how to get into torahanytime.com or to go to rabbanitirz.com, and I heard that people feel it very very easy to go into the YouTube. So it's also on the YouTube, Bezrat Hashem. And we are continuing with Tomer Dvorah B'Siyata Dishmaya. And we'll start with the month of Iyar. Iyar B'Siyata Dishmaya, we have 2 days of Rosh Chodesh. It's Wednesday and Thursday. Tomorrow night is Rosh Chodesh. Tuesday night is already Rosh Chodesh, which means now in our Erev Rosh Chodesh. And always I remind you, the name of Hashem, the right combination of the name of Hashem for the month that we are coming into. So Nisan was exactly like we have in the Sidurim, Yud Kei Vav Kei. For the month of Iyar, it comes from the verse, Italela Mitalela Skel Veyadua, that the person who is going to praise the name of Hashem will also have the knowledge of Hashem. And the combination is the initials of each word. So when we come to Musaf of Rosh Chodesh, when we say Baruch Ata Hashem, Mekadesh Yisrael V'Rashei Chodeshim, we say Baruch Ata Hashem, and just visualize and concentrate, not take the letters out of our mouth, but see it in front of our eyes, the letters of the name of Hashem, the combination for the month of Iyar. I'm reminding you that there are 12 combinations for all of the months, the 12 months, and they are from the name of Hashem, Yud Kei Vav Kei, the name of mercy, and from the name of Hashem, Eyeh Asher Eyeh, the name of Tshuva, of repentance to Hashem. And every month, only on the Musaf of Rosh Chodesh, we can concentrate. Now we have two opportunities, because we have Wednesday and Thursday of Shacharit, Bezot Hashem. So it's Yud Kei Kei and the letter Vav, and then the next name, the name of Tshuva, is Aleph, K.K. Vav. So dear ladies, just write it in your Sidurim, right next to it, the month of Iyar. I'm reminding you, Iyar is the month to be healthy. Ani Hashem Rofecha. Aleph in the month of Iyar is Ani. Reish Rofecha. And you have two Yudim at the middle, it's Hashem. I am Hashem, your healer. And it says, dear ladies, that the grains from Pesach, from the starting of the counting of the Omer until Shavuot, is rain to be healthy. So if it rains, open your mouth and drink the water. And ask from Hashem Yehi Ratzon that this will be for help. Why? Because on Shavuot, when all of the children of Israel received the Torah on the mountain of Sinai, they become all healthy. There wasn't any sickness. Anybody that was sick didn't have... had problems with his leg, his back, everything that you can think about, they became healthy. So the moment that we started the Sfira after Pesach, the moment we went out, the Siyata Dishmei of Egypt, until Shavuot, every day that the children of Israel went, it was one day that they went out of a gate of impurity into a gate of purity. When they were in Egypt, they went 49 gates of impurity. So the days that we count from Pesach until Shavuot is 49 days. The 50th day, the gate of Binah, the gate of wisdom, is Shavuot, the day that we received the Torah on Mamad Al Sinai. So they went from one gate of impurity into a gate of purity. The same thing happens every year. We can be the ones that will really receive the gates of wisdom will be open for us when we receive the Torah on Shavuot. Every year it's the same thing. That's why we read after Pesach, the first Shabbat after Pesach, and all of the Shabbatot until Shavuot, Pirkei Avot, Masechet Avot from the Mishnah. Why? Because we want to be with Derech Eretz, with courtesy, towards each other, not only towards Hashem, but towards each other. This is the main tikkun. We come back over here in reincarnation because we have sins between us and other human beings. So we study Pirkei Avot each Shabbat. We already started the first Shabbat, this last Shabbat, we started the first chapter of Pirkei Avot. This Shabbat will be the second chapter. If you didn't read the first one, read both of them on Shabbat B'Siyat HaNishma, and then continue with everybody, the third and the fourth, V'chulei B'Siyat HaNishma. And it says about in Bnei Yisachar, Rabbi Tzvi Elimelech Mendin of Zchutot Hagen Elenu, it says over there, from Vayikra Rabba, Perek Afchet, chapter 28, it says, Al tihi mitzvah ta'omer kala b'enech. I don't think that the mitzvah of the Omer should be light in your eyes. Because the days pass one after the other and we don't think really about the Omer. There's two Omer. There's Tnufat HaOmer. The Tnufat HaOmer is the day, the night after the first Chag was over, Pesach was over. The Jewish people, the very respectful Jewish men used to go around Yerushalayim in the tribe of Yehuda in order to cut the wheat, to cut it, and to grain and to grind it and to clean it and then to bring it as a sacrifice over the altar, al mizbeach. And it used to be with a lot of songs and a lot of rash around it, because everybody came. It would be with very happy. All everybody will sing. It will be in a good will. B'siyata nishma. Why? Because only then we were allowed to eat from the new harvest. Before that, we had to eat only from the old harvest. Only then we were allowed to eat from the new harvest. This is called Omer HaTnufa, that we pick it up, they used to pick it up and put it on the altar. And the other Omer is counting the Omer, mamash counting the days, because the Torah says, in Parashat Emor, the Torah says like this, Mi macharat ha-shabbat, mi yom aviyachem et Omer HaTnufa, which means after you bring Omer HaTnufa, this is the Omer that I said that they harvest the fields around Yerushalayim in the tribe of Yehuda. And when they do that and put it on the altar, then you have to count. Miyom aviyachem et Omer HaTnufa sheva shabbatot tmimot tiyena, which means you have to count seven shabbatot, seven shabbos. Tisperu chamishim yom, you count 50 days, which the 50th day is Shavuot. V'ikravtem mincha chadasha la'Hashem. And then you sacrifice and give a sacrifice to Hashem. It is mentioned in another place. It is mentioned also, Parashat Re'eh Chumash Dvarim. Over there it's mentioned, Shiv'a Shavuot ispor lecha. 7 weeks you're going to count. Me'achel charmesh bakama tachel ispor shiv'a Shavuot. So we start counting the 7 weeks and the 50 days after raising the Omer, after harvesting, after the most important men went to do this. And it was with a lot of happiness and it was a eruah.
Fanfare.
It was
fanfare.
Yes, it's like why? Because the tzadokim thought mimacharat ha-shabbat, tzadokim is the Jewish people that did not believe in the oral Torah, only in the written Torah. You know, the Rambam also had with them problems, because when he went to Egypt, over there, the ones that were ruling was rabbis of the tzadokim, the Karaim. They did not believe in the oral Torah, only in the written Torah. So the Rambam had to change everything in Egypt when he went to Mitzrayim to live there. And they used to do the Omer after, because ketuv mimacharat Shabbat. So after the first Shabbat of Chol HaMoed Shel Pesach, HaShabbat Shel Chol HaMoed. But Hashem meant after Shabbat, because also Yom Tov is called Shabbat, Mikra Kodesh. Shabbat is called Kodesh, Yom Tov is called Mikra Kodesh. So our sages said it means that after the first day of Yom Tov Shel Pesach. So that's why they made a lot of noise, that everybody will know that this is the day to start counting the Omer, because after that it doesn't come to 50 days. If you do it after Shabbat, it's not 50 days on Shavuot. So everything changes. So dear ladies, it says over here, why did Abraham Avinu get the land of Israel from Hashem. He inherited the land of Israel from Hashem for all of his generations. זכה אברהם אבינו לירש את הארץ, מורשה he got it, which means no one can give any part of the land of Israel to anyone, because this is מורשה, not, there are two words, there's ירושה, to inherit something that like our parents leave for us, we can sell it, we can give it to somebody else, we can do whatever we want with it. But מורשה, we can't. The difference between מורשה לירושה, it's forever, it's for generations. We cannot give it, because Hashem gave it to the children of Israel, and the children of Israel belong to Hashem, because in Shirat Hayam we say that Hashem bought us, שקנה את עמו, which means we are the slaves of Hashem. We are the children of, first children of Hashem. So we cannot choose not to be religious or not to fulfill the commandments, because this is who we are. This is the plan that Hashem planted in us. This is our identity, our essence. This is who we are. So we are bought by Hashem. Because we were bought by Hashem, we will be always Jewish. It doesn't matter what we'll do. Even if Chas v'Shalom, a person decides to be Christian or Muslim, he will always stay Jewish. He will be punished as a Jewish person in Olam Haba, in the true world. He cannot take this clothing and put it away and decide to be somebody else. It's who we are. This is how we were born. We are Jewish. And we are the firstborns of Hashem. So Avraham Avinu inherited Morasha, the land of Israel. We cannot give the land of Israel to anyone, because this is the land of Hashem, and he gave it to Avraham Avinu and his descendants forever, until the end of days. ונתתי לך ולזרעך אחריך, על מנת ואתה את בריתי תשמור. It says, why? Because you keep my treaty with you. And we do that every day. Every day we remind Hashem that we have a treaty. We say Shema Yisrael. And then we say Vahafta. And then we say Vahaya im Shamo Tishmu. If you listen to me, every day we renew the treaty with Hashem. Twice a day we do that. So Briti, you can tell me, but this is Brit Milah. This is circumcision. So Vayikra Rabba says, and Bnei Sachar brings it. It says Ve'eze mitzvat ha'omer. He means the treaty of the Omer. Why? And how is it connected? נכון שזה ברית, גם ברית מילה. But it's another thing, it's also the Omer. And look how beautiful it is. So Bnei Sachar says, because Omer, this is the Omer, Ayin is 70, Mem is 40, and Resh is 200. How much is it together? 310, נכון? This is Keri. Kuf is 100, Resh is 200, Yud is 10. How much is it? 300. This is sperm.
Oh. Wow.
Omer, in numerical value, is sperm. Zera, zera lebatala. Zera, brit mila.
That's
sperm. This is Omer. Omer is carry. So it's connected. Rabbi Chaim Vital says, ב'עץ החיים, בימי העומר טוב לתקן פגם הברית. מי היה חושב על זה? During the days of the Omer, it's good for a man to fix his spreading out his sperm in vain. כן, כמו השובבים, תראו, העומר. Why? Because Omer is ממש קרי, in גימטריה. And why? Because we cannot be a receiver and the vessel of Hashem's Torah after 50 days if we are not clean. Clean spiritually and physically. So if a man spreads his sperm in vain, he's not clean physically, not only spiritually, but also physically. Both of them. Rabbi Nachman Breslov says, the ten chapters of Tehillim that he put together, dear ladies, are 10 chapters for Tikkun Klali, for a fixing that is for overall, but especially for Tikkun Abrit. Especially for a man who has Chas v'Shalom, Zera Labatala, that spread his sperm in vain. It says about Avraham Avinu, look at Avraham Avinu, that kept the Brit, because he was the first one who did circumcision. He circumcised himself. He circumcised Ishmael at the age of 13, and all the Muslims are circumcised at the age of 13, but it's not a full circumcision. because they don't do priya. They don't take, they do the circumcision at kazat dam, but they don't do priya. And without the priya, it's not called circumcision. זה לא נחשב מילה. So dear ladies,
beautiful.
It says in Bereshit Rabba, chapter Mem Chet 48, it says, לעתיד לבוא, אברהם אבינו יושב על פתח גיהנום. In the true world, אברהם אבינו sits on the entrance of hell. And it says, ואינו מניח אדם מהול מישראל ירד לתוכה. And it doesn't give a Jewish person that is circumcised to go into hell. He saves him. But, ואותן שחטאו יותר מדי, those who sin too much and spread, because you remember we had shiurim about this, a few shiurim about this, because once a man has spread his sperm in vain, he creates demons. And they are his children. He just doesn't see them, but they are there. That's the only sin that it's almost unforgivable. Because he has to take this precious soul that now is dressed with a body that is impure, because how does this soul come to life, this demon? Because the sperm now is fertilizing the wife of Satan. And from this comes the demons. So the ones that sins too much, look what the Bereshit Rabba says. Ma oseh lahem, what does he do to them? Ma'avir, because if they are circumcised, he cannot bring them into hell. He's stopping them, he's saving them. So ma'avir et ha'orla me'al gabei tinokot shemetu, lo aleinu. He takes the orla, the part before you do the circumcision, the flesh that is on
the foreskin.
The extra.
Ma?
The foreskin.
Okay. The foreskin of babies, lo aleinu, that died when they were babies before they did Brit Milah, and he puts them on the ones that sin too much, ונותנה עליהן, that they will look like they didn't do any circumcision, ומורידן לא עלינו לגיהנום, and he puts them down in hell. And furthermore, מסכת עירובין,
who doing
this? אברהם אבינו. And מסכת עירובין, page 19, it says, כל אלה חייבים גיהנום, all of those that were judged to go to hell, בא אברהם אבינו, אברהם אבינו comes, ומעלה אותם, and he saves them. Just like it says Bereshit Rabba. Chutz, except for those who married a Goya, or been with a Goya, and didn't do tshuva, with non-Jewish woman, because you cannot mix. Hashem says, you are my firstborns, and I gave you kedusha, I gave you holiness, and I gave you more parts of the neshama. You cannot go and be with other people. You have to be only with Jewish people. מלבד, חוץ מאלו שבאו על הגויה, שנמשאו לתם, because they came on a goya, and they were intimate with a non-Jewish woman, it's like their flesh covers them, and it looks like they were never circumcised. So Avraham Avinu takes them and puts them down in hell, lo aleinu.
What covers them again, the klipot?
סליחה? זה כאילו הבשר שלהם מחפה על העבר שלהם. וזה נראה כאילו בכלל לא היה להם שום מילה.
But did they never come out from the
hell? Again, I think I gave it also over here. It says that Hashem is sitting and teaches Torah. And then he says a blessing and he hears from hell all of the souls over there starting to answer amen. Mm-hmm. And when he hears the amen, Hashem says to the Malach Gabriel, please go over there, clean them from the filth of hell, and bring them in front of me. But again, it depends on what level of sins a person does. And we had also lessons about it. We went through Beit Omer Torah B'Siyata Dishmaya. We had lessons. What happens to a person, about what sins he gets for the four deaths of the court, the Jewish court. And we went through a lot of things in Tomer Dvorah. So it depends what a person does. But nothing can stop tshuva. Why are we here? To do tshuva. So even if a person didn't know and he sinned, Hashem will accept his tshuva. Hashem accepted the tshuva of Menashe that did everything that wasn't allowed in the Jewish in the Jewish Torah. He did everything, and Hashem accepted his tshuva. Not only he accepted his tshuva, gave him another 33 years of being a king over Judea. Mal Yehuda, so there's nothing. And all of the angels, you remember I told you this, that Menashe asked Hashem, he was already cupped with iron chains, and they put him in a special pot. They wanted to boil him. Mm-hmm. And he prayed to all of the idols that he caused all of the children of Israel to pray. And he was a big scholar in Torah. His father was Chizkiyahu HaMelech.
What did he do wrong?
Was big.
Everything.
He did everything wrong. He had intimate relationships that were forbidden. He worshipped all the idols. He caused all the children of Israel, all of Judea, to do this. And he was the son of Chizkiyahu, which was a big king. Chizkiyahu was almost Mashiach.
What caused him to do that?
I'm going to speak about it, but wait with it. Write the questions. I'll just give you mentions. I'm going to speak about Chizkiyahu and Sennacherib through Tomer Dvorah in a few minutes. So, B'siyata Dishmaya, we can see that Hashem, Menashe spoke, they prayed to all of the idols and they said, save me, but nobody answered because there's no mamashiyut, there's no reality to the idols. And then he said, I remember my father, Chizkiyahu the king, and you need to remember that Yeshayahu the prophet was the grandfather of Menashe. It's not regular parents and grandparents. So when he prayed, he said, I remember the God of the Israelites, the God that my father told me about. I will pray to him. If he will save me, it means that he is the true God. And if not, chas v'shalom, so just like the others. So he prayed, and all of the angels went and closed all of the rekiim, all of the heavens, so his prayer won't come up. But quickly, they closed everything. So they told Hashem, you cannot accept his tshuva, his prayer. But Hashem said, if I won't accept his prayer, then the ones that sin so much won't know that they can come back to me. They will think that, Zo, everything is lost. Anyway, we sin so much, Hashem won't accept us, so we can do whatever we want. And then, בכלל ילם קרת מהעולם. And then they will eliminate it from this world and the next world. And no תחיית, no resurrection. No תיקון, no fixing. So Hashem himself, it's written that he made holes in each rakia in heaven that the prayer of Menashe will get up to the throne of Hashem. And he forgave him. And he put him back as a king, and he caused all of the children of Israel to do tshuva to Hashem for 33 years.
Wow, that's amazing.
That's Hashem.
It works.
That's Hashem. So dear ladies, let's look at it, B'siyata Dishmaya. Let's look at the word Omer. Because Avraham Avinu was all about kindness. He worshipped Hashem from the measure of kindness, chesed. So Omer, it's Ayin, the way we hear it, I'm writing the letters, Ayin. Then we have Mem, and then we have Resh. Ayin is 70, Yud is 10, Nun is 50. How much is it together? 80 plus, it's 130. Mem is 40, another Mem is 40, together it's 80. Resh is 200, Yud is 10, and Shin is 300. So it's 510. How much is it together? 720. What is 720?
Oh,
it's 72 10. Multiplied 10. By 10. It's Ayin, the 72 names of Hashem.
Wow.
What is 72? It's Chesed. Chet is 8, Samech is 60, Dalet is 4. It's 72. Chesed. Olam Chesed Ibane. In Tehillim, it says in chapter 89 that the world is built on kindness. That's why Avraham Avinu is connected to the Omer and connected to Chesed and connected to the Brit Milah, to circumcision. Because Chesed, Olam Chesed Ibane, a world is built on kindness. Every drop of sperm is a world because it's a whole human being. It's a potential of having a whole human being. When we get our period as women, and then after we finish our period, we have 7 days of clean days. Nachon?
Yes.
It's why 7 days? Like 7 days a person sits Shiva. Because there's supposed to be a life and there's not a life. So it's 7 days to be clean, to be cleansed. And then you go to the mikveh to purify yourself. Mm-hmm. So we see over here that it's Yud Pei, which means 10 times, Ayin Bet, 72, the names of Hashem, which is Chesed. What also is Chesed? Chesed Kel Kol Hayom, Tehillim chapter 52, which means the mercy of Hashem is the whole day. Without the mercy of Hashem, we wouldn't wake up in the morning. How many times we don't do that, what the will of Hashem? Look at the whole day. How many times we get angry, we are sad. It's not the will of Hashem that we'll get angry, we'll be sad. if we get angry, then it means that we have pride. Because we should remember that everything is in the hand of Hashem. All of our sorrows, all of our suffering, everything is from the hand of Hashem. Bless you. I wanted to explain to you what does it mean? That we don't have the all, you know, to put on ourselves the burden of thinking what to do. We just need to do ishtadlut, to make an effort and leave it to Hashem. All of the worries to Hashem, because He gave it to us. It's His. He is the owner of the world. Hu ba'al habayit. If He is the owner, yes. Az hu yada ma la'asot. If He knocked on our doors, it means that we need to do tshuva. We need to say chatati aviti pashata. We need to say thank you Hashem for knocking on my door. Bli neder, there's a beautiful lesson, maybe next week, Bli neder, about inside the Zriya Mezora, about the negaim. Aval bli neder b'siyata dishmeya, bli neder, because I have a few lessons that I owe you. I want to give it to you, bli neder, so it's part of it. And we see b'siyata dishmeya, if we leave it to Hashem, ma ze chesed, kindness. That the world is built from kindness, that we need to understand, that we need to appreciate each other. We all have a part of Hashem, of God inside us. So we are precious. If Hashem decided to bring us to this world, each and every one of you that is sitting over here, and each human being in the world is precious. Because it's part of Hashem. And Hashem is the owner of the world, and He brought us over here. We have a big job over here. And the world needs us. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here. When we finish our fixing, we go out of this world. But if we are still alive, the world needs us. So we see that this is chesed. And if we look at it, it's also a former Omer in numerical value is 310. The name of chesed of Hashem is Kel. One of the names of chesed is Kel. Lachen it's written, Chesed Kel Kol Hayom. And the Omer, I write it over here, we already made numerical value, it's 310. 310 is 31 multiplied by 10. 31 is Kel. It's the letter Aleph, and I write over here the letter Lamed. Aleph is 1, Lamed is 30, together it's 31.
What is Kel?
The name of Hashem. Hashem has a few names. This is Chesed. Chesed El Kol Hayom. ברוך שם כבוד מלכותו לעולם ועד. This is the mercy of Hashem every day. This is the name. How did Hashem take us out of Egypt? With this name of Hashem, Chesed Kel. I'll give another color. Chesed Kel. Kel Hotziyah Memitzrayim. Bilam says. This is the name. Why? Because the name Elohim of judgment, Elohim. This is a hay. I'm writing over here the hay. The Yud and the Mem, the Hayam, the ocean, the sea. So what did Moshe Rabbeinu do? He put the stick and divided the name of judgment of Hashem to Kel and Hayam, which this is judgment, inside the name of judgment. And this is mercy. That's why I gave you Shurim. You remember Hashem gave me the zchut to tell you that in judgment there's more mercy than in the mercy itself. Mm-hmm. In the judgment, there's more mercy than in the mercy itself. Because when Hashem knocks on our door, it's because we have a zchut to be in paradise. And He wants us to cleanse the dot that we have on a clear paper. Oh. So He divided His feet, and I gave lessons about this. Please refer to the lessons, that the name was split, and Hashem saved us with the name Kel. By splitting, b'siyata dishmaya, the name of judgment. So you can see that Omer is 10 times, is the Kedusha. Omer with full letters, when you write Omer, Ayin, Reish, Ayin, Mem, Bereish, full letters, it's 72 names of Hashem multiplied by 10, the Kedusha. Because in order to daven in a shul, we need 10 men. And you remember Moshe Rabbeinu is equal to 10 men. So we have Omer over here also, it's 10 times the name of Hashem of mercy. That's why we study, dear ladies, Pirkei Avot. Why? To have a good heart. What do I mean to have a good heart? To have a good eye. In order to have a good eye, we need to have a good heart. The heart is split to the right room and the left room. The right room is where the good inclination sits. The left room is where the evil inclination, Yetzirah, Satan, sits. In the left room of our heart. Now we have Ben Belial, Lo Aleinu, inside us. And a good person inside. We have a wicked person inside us and a good person inside us. So how do we conquer this evil inclination? By working on amidot, by working on our characteristics. The whole Torah is in order to make our soul gentle. Ze la'aden et hanefesh. That's why we learn the whole Torah. So, v'siyata dishmaya, we come to the Seir. Look how beautiful everything. In a minute, everything will be mechubar. We come to the Seir, and I'm going to Tomer Dvorah. We are now, v'siyata, we studied Mikel Kamocha, who is a God like you, Noseh Avon, who He carries our transgressions, and then Bover Al Pesha, that removes and eliminates, and you remember, it's only for specific people that He does this. The sin, which means it doesn't exist in reality anymore. Now we are skipping to the measure of v'tashlich b'mtzulot yam kol chatotam. And you're going to take all of the sins and throw it to the ocean. B'mtzulot yam, hayam. B'mtzulot yam, it's part of the name of Elohim. V'tashlich b'mtzulot yam et kol chatotam. And over there, Rabbi Moshe Kordover, Sotot Hagen Alenu, says this. Zo midat tova l'kadosh baruch hu. And we're going to study this also measure in a full, but I need to relate this to what we are studying now about the Omer. Zo midat tova l'kadosh baruch hu. This is a good measure of Hashem. Sharei Yisrael chat'u mesaram b'yad paro. The children of Israel sin, so Hashem gave them in the hands of Pharaoh, paro. Why? Because in order that they will b'siyat ha'dishmei do tshuva. The same thing happened with Madai, with Paras v'Madai. He put them in the hands of Haman. And then the children of Israel did tshuva, and Hashem saved them. So it says, after they sinned, Hashem put them in the hands of Paro, v'shavu b'tshuva, and they repented. Lama yanesh Paro? Why would Paro be punished? V'chen Sancharib, v'chen kol domehem, and also Sancharib, that was the king of Ashur, and he exiled several times the children, six times the children of Israel. First of all, the two tribes on the other side of the Jordan. He came and exiled the parts of the children of Israel a few times. Ein HaKadosh Baruch Hu mitnachem. Even though Hashem gives us suffering, He does not comfort Himself and forgives the people that cause us to suffer. Lomar shavu b'tshuva, im ken lo yeh lehem od ra, im ken yistalek haman me'aleim. Or Paro Sancharib, ze lo maspik. It's not enough for Hashem. So he will say, okay, Paro did what he needs to do. Now I'm leaving him alone and I'm taking the children of Israel. No, it's not enough for Hashem. Ela yashuv amal haman al rosho, but he punished Haman. Vechen Paro, and he punished Paro. Vechen Sancharib melech Ashur. And he punished Sanharib Melech Ashur. And I have to tell you something. Sanharib Melech Ashur, Hashem gave him that his descendants was studying Torah in Israel and teaching Hillel HaZaken. His descendants is Shmaya Avtalion. The king Sanharib, just like Sisra. Rabbi Akiva is descendant of Sisra. Just like Neron that came to conquer Jerusalem, His descendants is Rabbi Meir Baal HaNes. And from Sanharib, his descendants was Shmaya Avtalion. It's in Masechet Gittin. Dear ladies, I want to explain to you, look, how was righteous Chizkiyahu HaMelech that I told you about Menashe? Yeah. So it says in Masechet Sanhedrin, page 92, Tzadik Bet, Bikesh HaKadosh Baruch Hu La'asot Chizkiyah Mashiach. Chizkiyahu the king was almost Mashiach. V'Sanhariv, the king of Ashur, Gog u'Magog. Which means at that time, everything could have stopped. We would have been already in the times of Mashiach. Like for 2,000 years. In the times of Mashiach. But the only thing, and we went through this, the only thing is that after Hashem saved Chizkiyahu and all of the kingdom, all of the children of Israel, saved him from Sanherib, Chizkiyahu didn't sing to Hashem. Didn't say Shira. And Midat Adin, the judgment measure, came to Hashem. He says, King David wrote Tehillim for you. He was singing for you all the time. Singing and playing the instrument.
Maybe he doesn't know how to sing.
Doesn't matter. He should have told Hashem, if I don't know something, I ask from Hashem to help me to do it. See, that's the connecting to Hashem all the time. So the judgment measure came and said, Hashem, King David sang to you, wrote Tehillim, and you didn't make him Mashiach yet. And you're making Chizkiyahu Mashiach? So he wasn't Mashiach, and we are still in waiting for Mashiach. But I want to tell you what Hashem did to Sanharib. And I couldn't bring the books because it was too heavy for me. But it's in Sanhedrin, Masechet Sanhedrin. Page 96, צדיק ו. בא הקדוש ברוך הוא ונדמה לו לסנחריב כאיש זקן. השם appeared to סנחריב, the king of Ashur, as an old man. He disguised himself as an old man. ואמר לו, כשתבוא לפני מלכי מזרח ומערב, שלקחת את בני ונהרגו, מה תגיד להם? He said, well, you took a lot of soldiers from different kingdoms, from the west, and from the east, now that you, Angel Gabriel came, and he eliminated all of the soldiers and all of the army of Sanherib. So he tells him, now, when you go back and you were defeated like this, what will you tell the fathers of all those soldiers? Hashem tells him. He doesn't know it's Hashem. Amar Sanherib, גם אני מפחד על זה. He says, I'm also afraid of this. אמר לו, מה אעשה? He says, what shall I do? He asked us Hashem, what shall I do? אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא, Hashem tells him, לך ושנה עצמך. Make a change in yourself that nobody will recognize you. ומה שנה את עצמי? What shall I do? How can I change myself? אמר לו, לך והבא לי מספריים ואני אגזוז אותך. Go, he says, and bring me scissors and I will cut your beard and your hair. I'll make you bald and you'll look different, you know. When a person has beard and hair and then you cut it, you can't recognize him. Okay. Or he says, where shall I get it from? אמר לו, לך, היכנס לבית ההוא והווה. He says, go to that house and bring from there. הלך ונכנס. באו מלאכי השרת. The angels came, בדמות אנשים, disguised to human beings. והיו טוחנים גרעיני תמרים. And they were grinding the seed of the dates. אמר להם, תנו לי מספריים, please give me scissors. אמרו לו, תחון לנו חבית אחת גרעינים, you grind for us one package, one big package of these seeds of dates, וניתן לך. תחן להם ונתנו לו. He did this and they gave him. עד שחזר, until he came to Hashem, it was חושך. It was already dark. It took a long time. חשך היום, אמר לו, לך אבל יור. So Hashem told him, bring me light. הלך והביא אור, which means he brought fire. וכשהוא נפח באש, he wanted to make the fire bigger. כדי להלהיבו, אחז האש בשר עושו במשכנו, the fire was spread on his beard and his hair, ונשרף. כל השיער וכל... הלך וגילח את עצמו. Because of this, he already shaved himself. הלך ומצא דף אחד מתיבתו של נוח. At that time, he found one page from Noach's Ark. אמר, הנה האל הגדול. Wow, this is a... This, the king of the Israelites, is a big king. שהציל את נוח מהבד... That saved Noach מהמבול from the flood. That saved Noach from the flood. אמר, אם אלך ואצליח... If this king, if the king of the Israelites, will help me succeed, אקריב את שני בניי לפניו. I will sacrifice my two sons for the king of the Israelites. His sons heard this and killed their father.
Wow.
That was the end of Sanchariv. Which Sanchariv, Hashem wanted him to come on the children of Israel in order that they will repent, they will understand, they need to repent. What we see now in the world, it's only for us that we will repent. Once we repent, b'siyata dishmaya, everything is eliminated. You won't see all of this. The whole reality changes. Spiritually, we need to change. We need to respect each other. That's what we learn in Sfirat HaOmer, to respect each other. We count 49 days. 49 days in numerical value.
Angels are very tricky.
I know that we came to, in order to, b'siyata dishmaya, to manage the evil inclination with the help of Hashem, to do the will of Hashem, and not to listen to his not good advices. So we have, I told you, left tov. Lamed is 30, good heart. Lamed is 30, bet is 2, together it's 32. Tet is 9, Vav is 6, and Bet is 2. Together it's 17. 17 plus 32 is 49. This is the 49 days, Mem Tet Yamim, that we count until the 50th day of the counting, which is already Shavuot, that we receive the Torah. So we need to work that we will have a good heart. How do we change our ways? When we change our ways, we cause a change to the evil inclination, it becomes a good inclination. Instead that we will be a servant to the evil inclination and listen to it all the time, when we get angry, when we have lust, when we run after women or run after men, when we drink alcohol, do drugs, all of this is the evil inclination. We are slaves to the evil inclination. We are already in there, in its hands. So how do we do that? By studying Tomer Dvorah and Masechet Avot B'Siyata Dishmaya. Studying every, but it's not only reading it. Reading it's not enough. Why are we learning Tomer Dvorah in such depth? In order to really understand so we can change ourselves. Otherwise we didn't do anything. Rabbi Elimelech Milizan, Sodot HaGananel, says it can take 70 years to change one midah, one characteristic. But if we remind ourselves every day, even if we get angry, we remind ourselves, Hashem, sorry, I know it's not right. Abiti pashati. We say, I've sinned. We put charity. We kiss the mezuzah. We say, Hashem, please forgive. Wipe it out. That there won't be any impression in heaven over what are the things that we did now. And even if we have bad thoughts, because what happens, it starts with our thoughts and then it comes to our mouth to speak it out, and then our organ starts doing things with it. So even if we have, we need just to move them away, to remember Hashem, to just remember that Hashem is our Father and He will help us. We just need to ask Him for help. That's what you need to do. He is the boss. Like a small child, I remember my nephew, when his mother wasn't there and I was there, he says, okay. now that my mother is not there, you are the boss. So if a child knows who's the boss, we should remember who's the boss. Baruch Hashem, when he was young. So we see that this is Lev Tov, good heart, Bezot Hashem. How do we change? So I just told you about Kel, nechon? The name of the evil inclination is Samech Mem and Kel. This is the name of the evil inclination. This is holy. Chesed Kel Kol Hayom. The mercy of Hashem is the whole day. Olam Chesed Ibane. So this is holy. The Samech Mem is from here, is the impurity. But when we work on ourselves, we change it. And how do we change it? Write it over.
Kel is really
Kel. I wrote Kuf because I don't want the wipe the name of Hashem. So it's Aleph.
It would be
Aleph. Aleph. I remember that when I write Kuf, if I write Aleph, I can't wipe it. So dear ladies, with the Samech Mem, how can we change it? So I'm writing the Aleph Bet. Aleph Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey, Vav, Zayin, Chet, Tet, Yud, Chaf, Nun, Samech, Ayin, Bet, Sadi, Kuf, Reish, Shin, Tav. So when we repent and do tshuva, the Samech, Be'et Bash, when we change the letter, the first letter of the Hebrew Aleph Bet with the last letter, it's called Eight Bash. The first with the last, the second with the second to the last. So let's look at the Samech. The Samech over here is, this is Aleph is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yud is 10. Chaf is 20. Lamed is 30. Mem is 40. Nun is
50.
I had not right. 50. I have to continue counting it. So Yud is 10, Chaf is 11, Lamed is 12, Mem is 13, Nun is 14, and Samech?
15?
No, wait a minute. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This is Samech, 15. Okay. This is the Samech, okay? So let's go now from the end. From the end. I counted from this. We should count from the end first. Taf is 1, Shin is 2, Reish is 3, Kuf is 4, Tzadik is 5, Pei is 6, Ayin is 7, correct me if I forget, and Samech is 8. Okay, it's 15 from the first letter and it's 8 from the last letter. So let's go from the beginning, because Samech is towards the end. So let's go from the beginning, from Aleph. What is the 8th letter? Can eighth letter from Aleph, it's the letter Chet. We'll make it with a different
color. We don't need the 15 bichlal.
Chet. Let's go to Mem. Mem, if this is 8, if Samech is 8, Nun is 9, and Mem is 10. Nachon? From the end, from Taf towards the Aleph. So we need from Aleph towards Taf, the 10th letter. So the 10th letter, if Chet is 8, the 10th Taf, Taf is 9, the 10th letter is Yud. Is Yud. So Chet, Samech becomes Chet, and Mem becomes Yud. Together it's Chai. What is Chai? Chai, life. Yud Chet. The Samech Mem becomes life. At the end of days, the Mem is going to go out of his name, and he will be again one of the 72 names of Hashem. The letter Samech, the letter Aleph, and the letter Lamed. It's one of the 72 names of Hashem. Because the first human being sinned, the Mem that was floating over his head went into the name of the angel. And it became the Samech Mem. So it becomes Chai. Chai Kel. Chai, Chet is 8, Yud is 10, it's 18. Kel is, Aleph is 1. You remember the Kuf is Aleph. Aleph is 1. Lamed is 30, is 31. How much is it together? 18 plus 31, 49. Mm-hmm. The 49 days that we count of the Omer.
It is only a Moshiach come, like it's going like this, or
Ken, Bezat Hashem.
But not before?
Until Moshiach comes. But Moshiach can come now. We just need to, Bezat Hashem, remind ourselves that. That's like, you saw the students of Rabbi Akiva. 24,000 students of Rabbi Akiva in one plague passed away from Pesach Le'atzeret. So all of this is because they did not respect each other. So dear ladies, the lesson of the Omer B'Siyata Dishmaya, that we need B'Siyata Dishmaya to fix our characteristics. And we go back to the Seir. And about the Seir, it says that Hashem punishes the one that causes the children of Israel suffering. If it was Paro, if it was Haman, if it was Sancharib, all of them were punished. And הטעם לזה, תומר דבורה says, רבי משה קורדוברו says, והטעם להנהגה זו הוא בסוד ונשא השעיר עליו את כל המונותם אל ארץ גזירה. You remember that on יום הכיפורים, the high priest takes two goats that are even in height, even in weight, they are even. And one, by putting a גרלה פור, a lottery, one is for Hashem, and one is for, הולך לעזאזל, for the evil inclination. And the one that goes on for the evil inclination, the high priest takes all of the, he confesses over all of the sins of the children of Israel on it. Mm-hmm. And then a respected man takes it and they throw it in the desert over a cliff and it breaks to pieces. And this is the part of the evil inclination. This is like his present. Because all of the sins, you have to understand, he comes to prosecute the children of Israel if they have sins. But if all of the sins were removed to the Seir, they don't have any sins anymore. They're repenting. Mm-hmm. So all of the sins went into over the Seir. So where would the evil, the Satan will go? To the Seir, to the goat. That we throw that in the desert, because over there the desert is the place of demons, the place of the evil inclination. Okay, and that and the Bet HaChaim and the graveyard. So they throw it over there and he gets his pieces. So look what Rabbi Moshe Kordavor says. זכותו תגן עלינו.
אמן.
ופרשו שהסעיר נושא עוונות ממש. That the seir, that goat, ממש all of the, it's literally the sins of the children of Israel are upon him. וזה קשה מאוד and it's very harsh. וכי ישראל חטאו והסעיר נושא? The children of Israel did the sin and the goat has to take the responsibility of all of the sins. Ela midai kach. Ha'adam mitvade. The person is confessing. Ve'kavanato bavidui lekabel alav tahara. And one sick is confessing. He accepts upon himself purity. Ke'inyan she'amar David. Harev kapseni ma'avoni. King David says, kapseni, launder me from all of my sins by giving me those sufferings. וכן הוא אמר אלו מרוק ברחמך הרבים. זאת אומרת, cleanse us with your mercy. אינו מתפלל אלא שיהיו יסורים קלים. We ask from Hashem with small sufferings. The refrigerator went, the button fell, small things we ask from Hashem. אבל לא יד על ידי יסורים רעים, but not by harsh suffering. וכך הוא מכוון ביותו ואומר, ואתה צדיק על כל הבעלי. Which means once we have suffering, we accept the judgment of Hashem. We don't say, well, but I'm righteous, why do I have this suffering? הצור תמים פועלו ככל דרכיו משפט אל אמונה ונעוול צדיק וישר. Hashem is just. He knows everything that he does. So we accept the suffering. And we say, ואתה צדיק על כל הבעלי. ממש הוא מקבל עליו יסורים בסבר פנים יפות להתכפר. Only when a person accepts upon himself the suffering with a smile and says thank you to Hashem, מפני שיש עוונות שיסורים ממרקים או מיתה ממרקת. Because there's, so, and we spoke about it, sins that suffering can cleanse you, and there's sins that only death can cleanse you. וכך היא עמידה. מיד שזה מתוודה בתפילתו, so once you confess and you say to Hashem, I've sinned in your prayer, מפרש הזוהר הקדוש, the Zohar HaKadosh says in פרשת פיקודי, שהוא חלק הסמך מם. At that, why? Because the סמך מם caused you. Satan caused you to, this evil inclination caused you to do the sin. influenced you to do the sin. So it's like he gives you a present. Not a good present, but he gives you the present.
Some kind of bribe.
But now, once you said, "Achatati aviti pashati," I'm repenting. I'm cleansing myself. Hashem, I want to be in your way. Show me the way. That's Tonot Dvoram. Show me the way that I should go only in your way. Once I did this, I'm giving back the present. So literally, all of those sins go back to the even inclination. It doesn't belong because we now are purifying ourselves. So it doesn't belong to us anymore. And it says, שהוא חלק סמך מם כאין הסעיר. מהו חלקו? שהקדוש ברוך הוא גוזר עליו יסורים. That Hashem gives him suffering, this goat, ומיד מזדמן שם סמך מם, והולך וגובו חובו, and it comes and takes what is his. והרי נושא הסעיר אבונות, and this goat takes all of the sins of the children of Israel. שהקדוש ברוך הוא נותן לו רשות לגבות חובן. That Hashem gives him the permission that he will take all of these sins. וישראל מתארים, and the children of Israel are purified. והנה הכל יתגלגל על הסמך מם. Everything goes back to the סמך מם, to the evil inclination. והטעם שהקדוש ברוך הוא גזר על עולמו שכל מי שיעשה כן יתבטל. And then everything, a person that doesn't do good things is eliminated eventually, like Paro, like Haman, like Sancheriv. Hashem doesn't let them. It's like the stones that when there's stoning, when the Jewish court decided that a person should be stoned because of his sins, the stone is buried. If an ox killed a person, he has to be killed. Because the sword that kills, if a person was judged by the Jewish court that she'amut b'cherev, that a sword will take off his head, that he will be killed by a sword, the sword is buried.
Why?
Because it takes all of the sins with it. Because Hashem doesn't want that the people that will see the sword said, you know, this person was killed by this sword. Because at the moment that this person was killed, got his punishment, mm-hmm. He's already purified because this was the punishment in order to take off the sin that he did.
What happens to the goat? So this is part of the evil inclination.
Let me finish and then I'll tell you because it's almost 11. So please let me first finish. So I'm going to Pirkei de Rabbi Eliezer. And I would like to show you what he says about Yom HaKippurim, that we give the goat, that we put on the goat all of the sins of the children of Israel. Yom Shenitna Torah Amar Samech Mem. At the day of when the children of Israel received the Torah, the evil inclination said to Hashem, Lifnei HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Ribono Shel Olam, he says, Hashem, Al Kol HaRashaim Natata Li Reshut. You gave me permission to cause suffering to all of the wicked people. Ve'al Tzadikim Natanateni Reshut. And what about people that are righteous? You don't give me a permission to cause them suffering? Because you know, there cannot be a righteous person without one sin. אין כזה דבר. We are only human beings. כי אין צדיק בארץ שיעשה טוב ולא יחטא, King Solomon says. There's no righteous person that will do good on earth and won't sin. אמר לו, הרי יש לך רשות עליהן ביום הכיפורים. On יום הכיפורים, I allow you to do whatever you want with them. אם יש להם חטא, if they have a sin, if you think they have a sin, on יום הכיפורים, I allow you. ואם לא, if they don't have a sin, you cannot touch them, the children of Israel. לפיכך נותנים לו שוחד ביום הכיפורים. That's why we give him bribe ביום הכיפורים. שלא לבטל קורבן של ישראל, שנאמר גורל אחד להשם וגורל אחד לעזאזל. So we take all, it's the same thing of giving sacrifice on the altar in Beit HaMikdash. When a person sins, he brings a sheep or a pigeon, he brings to Beit HaMikdash, or he brings solet, flour to Beit HaMikdash in order to sacrifice it. and he sees what happens to the sheep or to the pigeon, and he knows this should be happening to me, and by this is purified. Why? Because it says in the Zohar Kadosh that a soul that sinned is in that animal, is reincarnated in this animal, and by doing this to the animal, the kosher animal, by doing this, it's his repentance, and then he can go to heaven. Don't look at things as they look in this world. There's a spiritual part in this world that we cannot see. You see, also in animals, I already told you, in animals, there's reincarnation of people that sin. So this is part of their fixing. So look what the even the Knesset says about the children of Israel, Yom Kippurim. So after he gets the goat, and the evil inclination, and all of the sins of the children of Israel is upon it, sees the Samech Mem, the evil inclination, שלא נמצא בהם חד, they don't have a sin. Because when we come at Yom Kippurim, we truly say it, and we believe that we won't do it again. So once we really say that and believe it, Hashem cleans us totally. And then he says, אמר לפני ריבונו של עולם, he says to Hashem, יש לך עם אחד בארץ כמלאכי השרת בשמיים. You have one nation that is just like the angels in heaven. He says, this is the evil inclination saying, Satan says on Yom הכיפורים, מה מלאכי שרת אין להם קפיצין, כך הם ישראל עומדים על רגליהם ביום הכיפורים. Just like the angels that stand all the time in front of you, the children of Israel on Yom הכיפורים stand and daven in front of you the whole day. מה מלאכי השרת אין להם אכילה ושתייה? The angels do not eat or drink. כך ישראל אין להם אכילה או שתייה ביום הכיפורים. The children of Israel do not drink or eat on יום הכיפורים. מה מלאכי השרת נקיים מכל חטא? The angels don't have a sin. כך ישראל נקיים מכל חטא ביום הכיפורים. Also the children of Israel are clean, they're cleansed from sins on יום הכיפורים. מה מלאכי השרת שלא מתווך ביניהם? Like the angels, they have peace between them. כך הם ישראל שלא מתווך ביניהם ביום הכיפורים. This is how the children of Israel are on יום הכיפורים. They have peace. Why? Because we say that we are davening on יום הכיפורים בכל נדרי, also with all of the people that sin towards Hashem. So we have peace with everyone. והקדוש ברוך הוא שומע עתירתן של ישראל מן הקטגור שלהם, and Hashem listens to them. Good advocate. He became a good advocate for the children of Israel. הוא מחפר על המזבח, and he, בסייעת הדשמיה, forgives the children of Israel on the altar. For the Kohanim, for the priests, and for all of the children of Israel, from the smallest one to the biggest one in the children of Israel. So you can see b'siyata d'shmaya that Hashem helps us to change the name of the samech mem, of the evil inclination, and to make it a good inclination. And how do we do that? By the counting of the omer. Because only by the counting of the omer we receive the Torah on Ma'amad Har Sinai, on Shavuot, on the mountain of Sinai, and the Torah was also given to us as morasha. The same thing. As inheritance that we cannot move aside and say, okay, I can choose either to follow the Torah or not to follow the Torah. No. It's a must to follow the Torah.
Birthright.
Yeah, it's a birthright that we don't have the right to think if I would use this birthright or not use it. We must use it.
But we're not counting like
women don't count, but I'm giving you the essence of the counting of the omen, dear ladies. So I would like to bless all of us, Bezat Hashem, with good heart. לב טוב, בעזרת השם, and that we will greet משיח צדקנו במהרה בימינו, אמן, and that בסייעתא דשמיא will hear אליהו נביא זכור לטוב, לעולם יפרד אדם מחברו בדבר הלכה יחיד ורבים הלכה כרבים.
אמן.
Which part of the Talmud Dvorah you read today?
It's the... זה פרק ראשון, it's the first chapter of Talmud Dvorah, and it's the ninth attribute of Hashem.
Okay.
חזק וברוך, תזכו למצוות.
סיגי.